working to set up the sale throughout the week. After worship today, we're going to start carrying things to the fellowship hall, and we will be setting up throughout the week. Please talk to Jean Thornberry. If you have any times you can donate in the morning, evening, afternoon, if you give her a call, she can make sure the church is open and give you a little direction as far as how you can help. We are also accepting baked good items. Thank you to everyone.
No? No?
Sorry.
Sorry. How's that for an important word? Have you ever used that word before?
Yeah? What about you?
No, never!
Uh-oh.
Hello! Hi, welcome. All right, so, sorry. It's a pretty important word. Do you know that word in Thai? You don't remember? All right, well, we say sorry. When might you say sorry?
When you do something bad.
Okay. Can you think of a time? What about a time when somebody has said sorry to you? No? Can you remember a time when somebody said sorry to you? You forget? Oh, so just it's being put on the spot, isn't it? All right. Well, sometimes we say sorry, and sometimes we say sorry to. Sometimes we say sorry to others, and sometimes we would like others to say sorry to us, or they say sorry to us, right? Just because we want them to say sorry, does that mean they do? No. Sometimes we really want people to say sorry, but they don't say sorry. How does that make you feel? When they don't say sorry? Yeah, we have a lot of negative emotions if we feel like someone should say sorry and they don't, right? But sometimes if we carry that around with us, whether someone says sorry or not, those negative emotions, that mad or sad, that's still ours. That's what we're carrying, right? We don't need that in our lives. But knowing that sometimes we like to hear sorry and how it makes us feel when we do hear it, how does it make you feel when you feel when you hear someone say they're sorry? You feel happy? I feel sometimes a little relieved, right? You feel a little better because there's been a hurt and somebody's trying to help fix it. And so knowing that that is a way that we can help fix others and fix ourselves, sorry becomes a very important and wonderful word. Have you ever done something that you felt kind of bad about and then you finally got to say you're sorry? And did you ever notice that it makes you feel a little better? Did you notice that? Yep. It is a very healing word, not only for us when we say it, but for the people who hear it. So, sometimes this is a word that I think we could use more often, don't you?
Yeah.
In fact, it's such a good word that when we pray, Jesus teaches us to ask for forgiveness, which is a way of saying sorry. So, when we say the Lord's Prayer, there's a part in the prayer where we say, "Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors." Does that sound familiar? We say it every Sunday. When we say it, that's our way of saying, "Dear God, we are sorry. We're sorry for the way that we have messed up, and we ask that you help us to forgive others who have messed up as well." So whether the other person says they're sorry or not, we put it into our prayer to make sure that we forgive them no matter what. Sorries are not always required for forgiveness, but they do go a long way towards it, which is why we always try to say we're sorry to God and we're sorry to others when it's necessary, when it's needed, and when it's helpful. But then we also remember that if somebody doesn't give us our sorries that we want, we can still forgive them. Which gives us a lot of power in this world. Helps us to be healing people for everyone, for ourselves and for others, which is pretty cool. So, you think you can work on apologies and forgiveness?
Yes.
Yeah? So what's our magic word for the week? Very good. And how about we add just an extra bonus? think we can add that one? Is that too far? No? We think we can do both? All right. Okay, let's have a prayer as we send ourselves into this very big mission of ours, okay? Dear God, we thank you for these wonderful words that give us so much power over our own hearts and emotions and healing in the hearts of others. Dear God, help us to say we're sorry whenever it can heal. Help us to recognize the hurts that we might cause, as well as the hurts that we feel, so that whether someone says sorry or not, we can always be strong enough to say, I forgive. In your name we pray. Amen. All right. Thank you very much.
He descended to the dead. transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you alone have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and blameless when you pass judgment. Indeed, I was born guilty, a sinner when my mother conceived me. You desire truth in the inward being, therefore teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me of hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear your joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Our last reading is from 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 12 through 17. I'm grateful to Christ Jesus our Lord, who has strengthened me, because he judged me faithful and appointed me to his service, even though I was formerly a blasphemer, a persecutor, and a man of violence. But I received mercy because I had acted ignorantly in unbelief, and the grace of our Lord overflowed for me with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. But for that very reason I received mercy, so that in me as the foremost, Jesus Christ might display the utmost patience, making me an example to those who would come to believe in him for eternal life. To the King of ages, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen.
Have mercy on us, O God. As we gather into worship, and we share our prayers, oftentimes our prayers deal with heartaches and pains that are weighing on us because of the thoughts of other people, whether it's their health and the security, or it's the stresses of everyday life that we encounter and we are wearing down. We also pray for our celebrations and all the ways we see God moving in our lives. But sometimes when we're left to our own devices, the prayer of mercy is set aside, especially in the better days. But when things get rough, when pain starts to take over our bodies, when hearts start to break, when the world seems to be on fire all over, suddenly the prayer of mercy comes to our lips. Why does it take a space where we feel that God is abandoning us before we recognize our need to have mercy and neighbor who struggled with a relationship. And it was a long relationship that stretched throughout her life. And then on her deathbed, as she's fighting cancer, she decided it was time to give mercy, to have a conversation, invite the other to say, "I'm sorry," but also find a way to move on. And if sorries were not given, then at least she could forgive. She talks about that relationship and that conversation when she finally decided to do this act of mercy, and she says the conversation was hard. It was hard and it was not necessarily pleasant, but that night as she went to bed, she only needed half of her pain medication. Lack of mercy seeps into our very bones and we feel it. When we let ourselves be overcome with rage or sorrow, we feel it. There is a reason why the ancients thought that our feelings and thoughts and emotions lay within our guts, because we feel our stomachs churn when we're disgusted. And we feel our hearts skip when we're excited. And we feel our muscles tense when we're angry. We feel the emotions physically. And that can take a toll if we do not let the good seep in. If we cling to our negative hates and hardships, we tend to let those powerful and painful emotions take over not only our hearts, minds, and spirits, but it seeps into our physical body too. And so our scriptures today are, in a sense, a wonderful nursing practice. Mercy. Mercy that we can ask for and receive from God. And mercy that we can give. God knows that life is difficult. Christ came to earth so that God can experience life for itself. The pain, the heartache, the feeling of being betrayed and dismissed, the feeling of physical pain and violence, the heartache of losing friends. God knows all of the pains of humanity. And so is generous in mercy. God knows all the pains of humanity and so invites us to mercy as well, because God knows how we are so tempted to cling to it, because for some reason, vengeance and hatefulness and bitterness and meanness seems in the moment to have more power than mercy. Something in our broken minds and spirits has told us, whether it is a cultural teaching or a personal teaching or somewhere in our lives, we've decided that these negative emotions give us power, because God knows when you're angry and your muscles are tense, how much more powerful does your body feel if you are tense? It's our flight or fight response that is our animalistic instinct that makes us feel powerful by nature, because if something is wrong, we are given that boost of power so that we can deflect it. But we put it in to all places when we're not called to fight or flight, we are called to mercy. So our brains have taken us for a ride, lying to us about what power is, when true power is that of This is a hard message to hear. And it is a hard message to give because I know full well that I am a hypocrite. I know that I can talk about love and mercy, and then sometime today my beloved spouse will do something that will make me cringe and tighten.
Sorry, yeah.
I know that I get irritable and angry and frustrated, and that it doesn't always come out in mercy as I would like, but my prayer is that I get there. And I surround myself with people I know who can find it in them to offer mercy as well, and encourage me to find my way back to it when I get lost. This is our gift of faith. God doesn't expect perfection, but continues to call us back. Invites us to mercy because God does it first, so that we can have the space to do likewise. May we go out with prayers of mercy on our hearts and lips, so that we might better align ourselves with the will of God instead of the chaos of nature, so that we might be focused on our true faith and not distracted by the hardships of the world. May we be blessed in this journey and this challenge, and may we find the peace that comes with mercy. The Lord be with you. St. John's, we celebrate many ways of giving, as you can see by the many clipboards and sign-ups in front of me. We have many opportunities of giving time and talents and give thanks and celebrate those gifts. We also give opportunity during worship to give gifts of tithe and offering that can be put into the plates or donated online through stjohns401.org. Our wooden plates are for our second mile. Each month we designate some offering to go to a new ministry that helps our community and our world. And this month we give to Neighbors in Need. Neighbors in Need is an offering through the United Church of Christ that specifically helps different programs and encourages opportunities in communities so that people can find a way out of difficult situations. Let us give as generously as we are able. The wood plates are for our second mile. The bronze plates are for our general offering to support the ministries of St. John's. If you have nothing to place in the plates, please hold them and give.